हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द एक्सपेरिमेंट ऑफ यूज ऑफ वर्नियर कैलिपर। दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट इज अ वर्नियर कैलिपर। यूजिंग दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट वी कैन मेजर डायमीटर ऑफ स्फीयर, डायमीटर ऑफ सिलेंडर, ऑल्सो वी कैन मेजर इनर एंड आउटर डायमीटर ऑफ हॉलो सिलेंडर, एंड ऑल्सो वी कैन मेजर हाइट ऑफ सिलेंडर एंड डेप्थ ऑफ हॉलो सिलेंडर। सो दिस वर्नियर कैलिपर हैविंग अ screw, this is a screw. Rotating this screw we can adjust the distance between these two jaws P and Q. We can say these two are lower jaws and these two upper ends P dash and Q dash are known as upper jaws or ears. There are two types of scale. First is main scale. This is a main scale on वर्नियर कैलिपर विच इज सिमिलर टू द स्केल ऑन मीटर स्केल। ऑन दिस विंडो हियर यू कैन ऑब्जर्व सम लाइन्स, दीज आर वर्नियर डिविजन्स। सो फर्स्ट लाइन ऑन वर्नियर डिविजन इज जीरो ऑफ वर्नियर स्केल। दिस वर्नियर कैलिपर इज अ मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट, सो एनी मेजरिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट हैविंग अ लीस्ट काउंट। Now, what is a least count? Least count is a least or minimum measurable value by that instrument. Here, first we have to find out the smallest division on main scale. So, smallest division on main scale denoted by symbol S. Here, on main scale between 0 to 1, there are 10 divisions. So, 1 division is 1 upon 10, that is 0.1, and main scale is in centimeter, so smallest division on main scale is S is equal to 0.1 centimeter. The total number of division on vernier scale, here these are vernier divisions. First line is of 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total number of division on vernier scale equal to N equal to 10, and least count is given by formula S upon N, which is equal to 0.1 divided by 10, which is equal to 0.01 centimeter. Next is to find the zero error. There are three types of zero error. First is no zero error, second positive zero error, and third is negative zero error. So to find out the zero error, we have to observe the position of 0 on main scale and 0 on vernier scale. See this diagram. So if 0 on vernier scale is coincide with the 0 on main scale, when lower jaws are touched to each other, then the vernier caliper having a no zero error, and the value of no zero error is 0. Next error is given, negative zero error, when the zero on vernier scale is left side of the zero on main scale, then the zero error is a negative zero error. In this diagram you can see the zero is on left side of zero on main scale. Then how to find out the negative zero error? Then we have to find out the vernier division which is coincide with the one division on main scale. So here suppose M is the division which is coincide with the main scale division. So we can find out zero error as minus into bracket N minus M into LC. So from figure here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 number division of on vernier scale is coincide with the one division on main scale. So zero error becomes Z equal to minus into bracket N is 10 minus M is 9 into LC is 0.01, which is equal to minus into 10 minus 9 is 1 into 0.01. So zero negative zero error becomes Z equal to minus 0.01 centimeter. In this way we can find out the negative zero error. Now to find out the positive zero error, so if the zero on vernier scale is right side of zero on main scale, then the error is positive zero error. Then find out the coinciding division on vernier scale, which is exactly coincide with the one division on main scale, and just multiplied it by least count, you get the zero error. Okay, so here 5, 6, 7 seven number division on vernier scale is exactly coincide with the division on main scale. So here m is 7, so 7 into least count is 0.01, and we get zero error as 0.07 centimeter, which is a positive zero error. Now find out the zero error in our instrument. So to find out the zero error, first touch the lower jaws, then see the position of zeros on vernier scale and main scale. So in this instrument, the zero on vernier scale is exactly coincide with the zero on main scale, so there is a no zero error, and the value of zero error is zero. Okay. So in this way we can find out the zero error in the vernier caliper. Next is to find out the diameter, inner diameter and depth of hollow cylinder. First is to find out the diameter of sphere. To find out the diameter of sphere, now put the sphere between the lower jaws like this, or fix the sphere between lower jaws, then see the position of zero on vernier scale. So the zero on vernier scale completes the reading on main scale is 2.4. Here you can see here is 3, so 2 is here, and after 2 there are 4 divisions. That means this zero on vernier scale completes the division on main scale are of 2.4 centimeter. So our main scale reading is 2.4 centimeter. Then find out the vernier division. Now to find out the vernier division, find out the vernier division which is exactly coincide with the main scale division. So here you can see this 6 number division is exactly coincide with the above division on main scale. So 6 is our vernier division. Our main scale is 2.4 and vernier coincident vernier scale division is 6. Now next is vernier scale reading is equal to B into LC, that is 6 into LC 0.01, we get 0.06. The total reading is A plus C, so 2.4 plus 0.06, we get 2.46. Corrected reading is T minus Z, so we are having Z equal to 0, so we get corrected reading is equal to T, which is equal to 2.46. Similarly, take two more readings for diameter of sphere, we get total reading 2.46 and 2.45 and 2.46. Now mean reading is the mean of these three readings. Add these three readings and divide by 3. So we get mean 2.456, which is taken as 2.46. Now to find out the inner diameter of hollow cylinder. To find out the inner diameter of cylinder, you have to insert the ears or upper jaws of vernier caliper inside the hollow cylinder. You can insert the ears or upper jaws of vernier caliper inside the cylinder. Then in the similar way, you can find out the readings of inner diameter of hollow cylinder. So here the main scale reading completed by
0 on vernier scale is 1.4. So the main scale of vernier caliper completed by 0 on vernier scale is 1.4 and the vernier division is 2. Second number division of vernier scale is coincide with the main scale line. So 2 is the vernier division. Main scale is 1.4 and 2 is the coincident vernier scale division. So we get C equal to 0.02 and total reading is 1.4 plus 0.02 which is equal to 1.42 and the corrected reading is same as that of total reading. After taking two more readings, we get total reading for inner diameter of cylinder as 1.42, 1.43 and 1.41. Find out its mean which is equal to 1.42. Now next measurement is of to find out the depth or length of hollow cylinder. So to find out the length of hollow cylinder, you can keep the cylinder between lower jaws and take a readings, note down main scale reading and vernier scale reading. So here main scale reading is 5.1 because the zero on vernier scale is very close to 5.2 but it's not completed. So we are taking the main scale reading as 5.1 and the coinciding vernier division is of 8. 8 number division on vernier scale is exactly coincide with the main scale. So 8 is the vernier division. 5.1 is the main scale reading and coinciding vernier division is 8. So C is 0.08. Total reading is 5.18 which is equal to the corrected reading. Take two more readings. After taking two more readings, we get the length or depth of hollow cylinder as 5.18, 5.16 and 5.16 and its mean is 5.166 which is equal to 5.17. Now to find out the volume of sphere, find out the radius of sphere. Here we get the radius of sphere, mean radius of sphere is 2.46. So R, capital R is equal to 2.46 divided by 2 which is equal to 1.23 centimeters. So radius of sphere is 1.23 centimeter. Using this radius we can find out the volume of sphere. V is equal to 4/3 pi r cube. To find out the volume of sphere, we have to do log calculations. So for log calculations, first column is of symbol, second is value and third is log. So in the column of symbol, first write the quantities on numerator. So in this formula, the quantity 4 pi r cube is on numerator and 3 is on denominator. So value, first value is 4, then second is pi, it is written in the column of symbol. Next is r cube, so r is written 3 times. Now put the values of r, we get r as 1.23. We have the value of r, that is radius of sphere is 1.23. Now find out the log of these values. After finding the logs of these values, we get log of 4 is 0.6021. Log of 3.14 is 0.4969. Log of 1.23 is 0.0899. Log of 1.23 is 0.899. Log of 1.23 is 0.0899. Now these all terms are on numerator, so log of these all values will be added. So addition is 1.3687. Now subtract the log of 3 from the value 1.3687 and log of 3 is 0.477. So we get subtraction 0.89 16. Now find out the antilog of this value, which is a volume of sphere, and write in the column of value. So the antilog of 0.8916 is 7.791, which is the volume of sphere. Now to find out the radius of cylinder, we have the diameter, inner diameter of cylinder is 1.42. So we get the radius of cylinder as small r is equal to 1.42 divided by 2, which is equal to 0.71 centimeter. Now to find out the volume of cylinder, we have formula V is equal to pi r square h. Here we are taking radius of cylinder as small r, so write the formula as pi small r square h. For log calculations, prepare a calculation table. First column is of symbol, second is value, and third is of log. So write in the column of symbol pi, then r square, so write 2 times r and h. Then write the values of these quantities. Pi is 3.14, r is 0.71, and h is length or depth of cylinder, which is 5.17. Now write the log of all these values and add it. Log of 3.14 is 0.4969. Log of 0.71 is bar 1.8513. Again, log of 0.71 is bar 1.8513. Log of 5.17 is 0.7135. Now add all, we get 0.9130. Now find out its antilog. We get 8.185, which is a volume of hollow cylinder. So write in result volume of sphere equal to 7.791 and volume of cylinder equal to 8.185 centimeter cube. So there are some precautions we have to take while doing experiment. First is, hold the object tightly between the jaws. Do not press the jaws too hard. Second, take observations for diameter at a different position of the object. Third is, eye should be exactly perpendicular to the vernier scale while observing readings. Thank you.